to matter one, issue one, which is about the duty to corporate. What I intend to do is to return to the council the quality of IT to introduce those participants who are going to speak in the session. I would then invite you to agree with the summary of council's position in terms of the duty to corporate. Obviously, you've submitted the last level to the back of the spoke as briefly as open so on the next duty to corporate. In particular, I identified the strategic matters and then worked through duty to corporate.
Okay. Thank you very much indeed, sir. So, would you also at this stage just go around the table to see who the others are who wish to participate?
Yes, I will. Why don't you just introduce your team, Mr. Katkowski, and then we will introduce you.
Great, thank you very much indeed. Well, I'm still Christopher Katkowski, Queen's Council, I hope, and sitting to my right and participating in this particular session on the duty to cooperate, I'll just ask the people to my right to introduce themselves.
Thank you, good morning. I'm David Coleman. I'm a planning consultant for the Board of Council.
Good morning, Tim Parson, planning consultant for Borough Council.
Good morning, John Anderson, principal for planning officer for Borough Council.
Thank you. Can I start with the subject of Borough?
So thank you, Mayor. Because I appear on behalf of leadership. My name is Christopher Boyle, King's Council, is my name. Attaches there. I'm instructed by Stratton Park on behalf of UQ. And to my left is Oliver Neagle of Stratton Park, and again on behalf of Belgium.
Thank you.
Good morning, sir. I'm Joe Russell. I'm Town Director at Stoneford Developments.
Good
morning. I'm Stacey Green, Planning Manager at Stoneford Developments.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. So, in relation to the duty to cooperate, which is issue number one, on the heading of matter one, you've asked a series of four questions. Are we taking them, forgive me for asking this, are we taking them one by one, or are we taking them in a run to bring together?
Yes, I think that we would probably take them together. I think we're going to move around a little bit. And since we've got a manual new participants, just treat them as one for now in terms of what you can say, and then we will. We've got some questions.
So, in these opening remarks and in relation to the duty to cooperate, if I just give an overview, as you know, our written examination hearing
nothing but substance being provided in the centre and basically provided, because these are not target generation areas. Now therefore the distribution leads to a consequence in terms of the type and tenure being delivered, which is a mismatch to the needs and has a consequence if they physically attend to distribution, but also what it means. This has potential consequences as a strategic matter across the others, because the relationship Wirral is maybe a peninsula, but it is not an island, and its relationship to the south of the west, I wish I had back to the point, that south of the west is important. If you can use shovel and stuff of one type in one corner, what does the absence of other types in other places do for those other districts? And that's where the DTC point comes in.
And in that sense, and those other districts are Cheshire West and Chester. And oh, sorry, you haven't got a map.
I don't. Can I come to? Unless Mr. Neagle can assist, he may have a handout. For some reason, we've got no internet on this site.
Yes.
But and I don't have the list, therefore, that's in the beginning of the two properties that you can find.
It would be West Lancashire.
West Lancashire Borough Council, Pembrokeshire County Council, Cheshire West and Cheshire.
The map, by the way, says electronic page 10 of SGD1.
I don't know why you haven't got internet.
I think it's my corporate VPNs.
Oh, I see. There is a nice map of page 10 of the document. Oh, you've got to move them as well.
Have the microphone, yep. Please.
Yep. Forgive me, I've just realised. Page 10 of the electronic document, SGD1, has a nice coloured map.
So there has been engagement with those thoughts. Those three authorities you mentioned are listed.
But not as far as we can see all this.
I understand that. Presumably, though, the argument holds if, say, we were to agree with you that the particular approach being proposed would have an implication in terms of, I think you mentioned, house size provision, affordable housing. So it's a sort of contingent that we agree with you on that point, then you would argue that the duty to cooperate was failed on the basis of not taking appropriate account of those facts.
Well, yes, with this caveat, that when I say it's principally and it's going to be 10% or less for housing. That's not me speaking, that's the authority's own evidence, because that's what they're proposing.
Does council wish to come back on that point? Council have discussions with the authorities, and is evidence within the state of compliance. Is there anything that you could help us with on the point that is forward raised?
Indeed, but if I may respond, thank you, sir. I'm going to resist responding to what I would regard as inaccurate summaries of our strategy. We're going to be talking about our strategy in due course. We will hopefully have a discussion in which we look at the detail of the strategy and understand exactly what it is. So I'm not going to rise to the debate of
agreed with the strategy to meet Wirral's housing need in Borough. It suggests that there has been consideration by that authority of the overall strategy in the Wirral local plan, which must have gone through a duty to a corporation.
Well, again, we're getting dangling into the outcome of the process. If they didn't even discuss the potential for the consequences, positive or negative.
hang on, did you say page 35?
Yeah, 35.
Thank you. That's helpful. I am there.
Okay. So just in summary, the council held a workshop